temporary wooden retaining wall, a passboard problem. Hi, hello, welcome back to Gilisanya Engineering Videos, your daily supply of solutions to engineering problems. If you like what you see, please subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we upload new videos. Okay, in this video, we will discuss a passboard exam, one that always recently palaging lumalabas sa examination natin, CE board exam. Okay, temporary retaining wall, wooden retaining wall. Alright, so ito yung problem natin. Wooden planks 300 mm wide and 75 mm thick are used as a temporary earth retaining wall driven vertically into the ground. The wall is designed to resist 2.4 meters height of soil. Unit weight of soil is 17.8 kilonewtons per cubic meter with active pressure coefficient of 1/3. Allowable bending and shearing stresses in wood planks are 12 MPa and 0.75 MPa respectively. First question is the maximum bending stress in the plank. Alright. Second is the maximum shearing stress in the plank and the required plank thickness to avoid failure. Actually, if you read the problems, the questions are very easy. This is just direct substitution. The only problem here is the interpretation because there is no figure given. How do you interpret? How do you analyze or visualize this wall? If you can do that, then this is a very easy problem. Just recently, this came out in three successive exams. Just recently, lumabas na rin to. Na? Okay, so ito yun, no? Wooden planks. How do you put or orient that as a wall? Huh? Okay, so imagine this one. This is the ground. Okay, then the orientation of the planks are like this. Look, like that. Obviously, yeah. And then fill it with, of course, the soil. All right. That's it. Of course, planks should be embedded deep onto the ground. Alright? So, and then the height or the height of the wall being retained or soil retained is 2.4 meters. That's it. Then the thickness should be, okay, this should be the 75 mm here. This is the 300. Okay, that should be the 75 and this should be the 300 mm. So, these are the planks. No? Hindi naman siguro pwedeng baliktarin natin. Pwede naman siguro 300 dito, 75 doon. Pero sa tingin ko, mauubos yung kahoy natin. Ha? And besides, this is just temporary maybe. Temporary wall lang. It will be removed later on. Alright, so this it. Okay, so to analyze this one, we can, as you can see, the each plank are loaded at the same yung intensity of loading ng kada plank ay the same. Hindi nagbabari. Alright? So, we can consider this plank only or better if we consider a unit width na lang. A 1 meter width like this. You can do that. Okay? And this is actually a cantilever beam. The force acting on the plank, okay, its weight will not affect, no? Will not cause any bending moment, no? So, the force acting on the plank is the active soil pressure and it acts like this. Okay? Ayan. Okay? So, okay, tawagin natin F. And of course, being triangle, the location of that is 1/3 of H from the bottom. This is the critical point. This is where the maximum moment and shear is. Right? So, your H here is 1/3 of 2.4, that is 0.8 meters. So, the active pressure coefficient or the total active pressure is given by this formula. 1/2 Ka gamma soil times H squared times the width. In this case, the width that we'll be using is 1 meter. 1 meter. We could have used the point or 300 mm if you want. Now, anyway, the answer will still be the same. So, I will just use 1 meter here. So, your Ka is 1/3 and your gamma soil is 17.8. Then we can solve here the total force acting. And that's 17.09 kilonewton in every meter width of the wall. Okay. So with that force known and the line of action is known, we can compute the reaction moment. Okay. So ito yung ating moment. reaction moment. Okay? So that moment is equal to F times 1/3 or 0.8. Then that will be 13.67 kilonewton meter. Then the shear here will be equal to F. This is the maximum shear. The maximum shear is equal to your F also. Okay, so we now have the bending moment and the shear. Then, if we consider the axis of bending, if we magnify that part there, it will be like this. This is the segment, or this is the section that we are analyzing. This is our axis of bending. Alright, the width is 1 meter, 1000 mm, and the depth is 75 mm. We know the moment, we know the shear, then we can now compute the bending and the shearing stress. Okay? For the maximum bending stress, we can use the rectangular beam formula, 6M over BD squared. Your M is known, your B is 1000, and your D is 75 mm, and the answer is 14.58 megapascals. So that should be letter B. Part 2, the maximum shearing stress, we can use also the formula for rectangular beam. The formula is 3V over 2BD. Maximum shearing stress, 3V over 2BD. So your V is 17.09 kilonewton. So convert that to newtons. So the answer is 0.342 megapascals. And that is letter C. Okay. And then part 3, calculate the required plank thickness to avoid failure of the wall. To avoid failure of the wall. Now, as you can see, so with this dimension here, the bending stress is 14.58, and that is more than the allowable. The allowable is 12. But the shear stress is very small, 0.342. The allowable is 0.75. So it will be safe with shear, but not safe in bending. So obviously, if you design the, if you compute the thickness, we might consider na lang siguro the bending. Na? Para baka save ka ng time. You don't have to consider anymore the shear. But I did both here, but that is just an idea, no? In doing this kind of problem or type of problem, you can do that. No? So we will anticipate here that what will govern here is the bending. So let's check. Part 3. So we will compute the depth, the thickness. So this in this case, the D is the one unknown. So unahin natin based on bending. So based on bending, so dapat the maximum bending stress must not exceed the allowable bending stress of 12 MPa. Alright, so your allowable bending stress is 12 MPa. So your M is known already. Now B is 1000, your D is unknown. Then it will become like this. And it shall not exceed 12 MPa. Then from that, your D must be greater than or equal to or must not be less than 82.7. So we will anticipate that this will govern our investigation. Now let's try to look at this. If we base that on shear, shearing stress is 3V over 2BD and it must not exceed 0.75 MPa. If you substitute, the shear is 17,090 over 2BD and that shall not exceed 0.75. Your D is equal to 34.18. Napakaliit. Kaya among the two, D must not be less than 82.7 mm. So, must not be less than. Ha? So, as you can see, what will you choose? So, we cannot choose 80. Any value more than that is okay. So, of course, here the minimum is 85. 85 is the most, shall we say, economical. Although we can choose 90 and 95 for that. Because the statement here, it says it shall be greater than or equal to. But not 80 here. Alright, so 85 is the correct answer. Alright, so I hope you learned a lot from this short video. So this is a passport and recently, palagi itong lumalabas. Sana may natutunan kayo sa video na to. Okay? So, please don't forget to like, this video and paki-share naman sa mga friends ninyo. So, don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so that you'll be notified every time we upload new videos. So, thank you so much for watching.